Monday, Kansas legislators took the pledge and gaveled in for the start of their 90-day legislative session. The first order of business is deciding new legislative, congressional, and state board of education districts. A House committee began work on that Wednesday.
It's really important because there's a lot of people that are interested in this. It's a math problem, but it's a math problem with a lot of emotion, right?
Tax reform is likely to be a big issue in many ways, and you can bet they'll be discussing if and how to spend a massive budget surplus in the billions. Joining me now to look ahead to what's in store for this session are Democrat Senate Minority Leader Dinah Sykes and Republican Senator and candidate for Kansas Attorney General Kelly Warren. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us today. First, let's get to redistricting. We had Vicky Hyatt with the Kansas Democratic Party on a couple of weeks ago. She is worried that Republicans will work to break up Wyandotte and Johnson counties in the 3rd Congressional District to try to get Democrat Sharice Davids out. Senator Warren, what is the thinking among Republicans right now? Are you able to come to a fair agreement with Democrats on this, or does this just go back to the courts like it did last time?
Well, I think we're always looking to work together and to keep communities of interest together. So that's what the Republicans would be expecting to come out of the legislature.
Do you want to break up Wyandotte and Johnson counties? Do you think that that's likely?
I think, again, we need to keep communities of interest together and take a look at the 3rd District and what that looks like.
All right. Senator, what are your concerns?
There has been the concern of splitting Wyandotte County and the talk of some people wanting to put it into the Big First. There's very different communities there, so I hope we can resolve that.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's talk, you're a Democrat in a legislature that has a heavy Republican majority, it's safe
yes.
to say, right? What are your priorities? How do you make them happen? I know constitutional amendments are at the top of the list for Democrats this year.
Yes, for the House Democrats, that is true. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, you know, it's relationships that you're building, and at the end, you have to have 21 votes to move something forward. And, you know, depending on the legislation that is in, it's 21 different people, probably 9 times out of 10.
Missouri has medical marijuana, as you know. Kansas does not. Does that change in 2022? Do you think it'll be legalized?
I don't know. We saw a bill come out of the House last session, very late in the session, so it wasn't addressed by the Senate at all. And I don't know if there's going to be an effort to take that up in the Senate this session or not, or whether it will be something different coming out of the House, but something to look at.
Is this something you support?
I have supported it, and I think from all conversations that I've had, there will be hearings and wanting to have some movement on that.
All right, so time will tell on that. Let's talk taxes. Tax reform will likely play a big role in Topeka this year. The governor has said that she wants to get rid of the food tax, X the food tax, she says, and wants a clean bill to make that happen. Do Republicans want more here, or are you going to try to tack more onto to that measure?
I don't know. We'll have to take a look and see what the bill looks like, what it does to the budget, and how it affects Kansans. Certainly, Kansans want some tax relief this session. We see high prices being paid at the gas pump. We see high property taxes in Kansas as well. So there's a lot to take a look at, and food sales tax would be one thing.
Mm-hmm. And we mentioned this a minute ago. Kansas has this huge surplus now projected to be, it's going to be something like $2.89 billion. Governor Kelly has a lot of ideas, including the $250 rebate. Is there anything more that Kansas legislature wants to add to that? Do you support that measure?
I think we definitely need to look at it, and that's a good use of one-time funds, so it's not something that we're going to have on the books for coming years. Absolutely support Ax the Food Tax. I've sent out the bill to all Republicans in the Senate to have them look at it, hoping to get co-sponsors on that. But if we really care about all Kansans, we will pass a clean bill and get it to the governor's desk soon.
Senator Warren?
It's one thing to look at. I hear a lot of folks looking at, let's make capers solvent. Let's use the surplus that we have right now in a good, responsible way. And lots of different things to look at about that.
What are the biggest items right now that you don't think are getting enough attention?
I think rules and regulations. We have a lot of rules and regulations. We've seen too much bureaucrats making policy, and we need to work on our ability to claw back our authority as the legislature for policymaking, get it to the people who are accountable to the voters, and get that in place. And also, we might be looking at judicial selection reform. I'm not sure what's going to be coming out of session this time, but it's something to take a look at that's been around the legislature, around the Capitol for a number of years.
What would you like to change specifically?
Well, there's lots of different options. People talk about, well, let's make the selection of Kansas Supreme Court justices more like the federal model. I think most Kansans don't realize that we don't have any Senate confirmation process for our Supreme Court justices. Some suggest direct elections. Some suggest, well, let's take take the system that we have right now and make it more accountable to the people. Again, more accountable, government should be more accountable to the people, government of and by and for the people.
And Senator Sykes, what's on your list?
Well, Medicaid expansion is always there.
It's a big one.
Yeah, 160,000 Kansans who could have access to affordable health care. Definitely important. I don't think it is on the other side of the aisle. And I think, we're elected to represent our constituents. And so it's always, how do we best do that?
Last question it's the elephant in the room, COVID, right? Because this could affect how you do business in Topeka. It's also affecting lives in Kansas. We have more and more Kansans every day going to the hospital for COVID infections. The legislature called itself into session to fight vaccine mandates. Are we gonna see more of that from Republicans? Because not everybody got what they wanted there.
I think the result of the special session that we had in November was to, again, look at government overreach and make sure that we're not subject to it, quite frankly. It's our responsibility to stand up to government overreach and make sure that we have laws in place to protect your liberties and to kind of find that balance, right? We have the balance of what government feels it needs to do to keep folks safe and what you feel is your private and individual liberties and what's in the Constitution. So I think the legislature, I think the Senate will continue to look at maybe reforming the Kansas Emergency Management Act. And we had the Supreme Court last week rule that SB 40, which did address the Kansas Emergency Management Act last session, wasn't unconstitutional in the case that was brought before it.
All right, and real quick, because we're running out of time, what would you like to see on the COVID front?
You know, I think Senator Warren is right. We were looking at kind of balancing that, but we put together a separate mandate. So it's just the reverse, but it's still a mandate. And I think the best act moving forward, getting vaccinated, wearing masks, being responsible.
All right, Senators Dinah Sykes and Kelly Warren, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.
Thank you.